The motion to censure the state minister for housing, Persis Namganza, was moved in parliament on 23rd December 2022 by the Agago North MP John Amos Okot with 196 signatures in support.
I beg to move a motion for a resolution of parliament to pass a vote of censure against Honourable Persis Namganza, Princess, State Minister for Lands, Housing and Urban Development. Just like you have quoted, I move under rules under Articles 118 of the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda, as amended 1995.
The Deputy Speaker, Thomas Tayewa, emphasized that Parliament was to stick to the procedure in censure of Honorable Namganza. After notifying the President on the motion, the House has been called to sit on Friday 6th to constitute a select committee to scrutinize the motion of censure.
This is a very serious matter that is also clearly provided for under Article 118 of the Constitution. So the moment I just refer to the rules only, and yet the Constitution gives a very clear procedure, I think we shall be arming someone to say you never proceeded the right procedure to process the motion. So I would request you agree with me, Honorable Tinker, that indeed we don't suspend the rule, we follow the procedure.
According to Rule 109 of the Parliamentary Rules of Procedure, the committee, which is created 14 days from the date of transmission of the motion to the president, is supposed to scrutinize and identify prima facie evidence, the allegations in the motion, and it may receive supplementing information from any member of parliament. The minister in question is given the opportunity to appear before the committee to defend him or herself against any allegations made against him or her. And this select committee has 15 days to report back its findings to the House.
The order paper also talks of a select committee that's supposed to be appointed by Parliament to look into the issues of censorship of Honorable Minister Namganza. This is to give a fair hearing on both parties, which I think is really called for.
See, those are the formalities. When you are censoring somebody, you don't just come from nowhere and tell police we have been censored. They are procedures. So those are the procedures. After the motion, vote on it, the 72 hours, then the president, then a committee for social and natural justice, so that the complainant, together with the defendant, are given a chance to appear before the committee and they give their own submissions accordingly.
MPs have acknowledged the receipt of the memo from the clerk to parliament, summoning them to cut their recesses short and return on duty to handle the censure matter, among other issues that have been detailed on the order paper. Some were left wondering why the House resumes on an odd day, since usual parliament sittings run between Tuesday and Thursday.
Yet we are in recess, which we can call a Christmas holiday. This is the time when we interact with our voters. We ask them what is bothering them and they tell us. Then we come back here and we view each and everything so that we see how we can make our constituents move smoothly.
Informed that there are about three matters on the order paper. One about Namganza, then two, delayed payments of contractors, and another matter that I haven't clearly understood.
Among other issues on the agenda is the debate on the report by the Committee of Fiscal Infrastructure on the delayed payment of the hired contractors. MPs are concerned that contractors across the country have abandoned government projects due to delayed payments by the government. Engineer Richard Sebalama, a member of the Fiscal Infrastructure Committee, says government accrues interest worth 300 million shillings daily due to delayed payment of contractors. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.